When Jethro, the priest of Midian, Moses' father-in-law, heard of all that God had done for Moses and for Israel, his people, and that the Lord had brought Israel out of Egypt, then Jethro, Moses' father-in-law, took Zipporah, Moses' wife, after he had sent her back, and her two sons, of which the name of the one was Gershom, for he said, I have been an alien in a strange land. And he delivered me from the sword, and the name of the other was Eliezer, for the God of my father said he was mine help, and delivered me from the sword of Pharaoh. And Jethro, Moses' father-in-law, came with his sons and his wife unto Moses into the wilderness, where he encamped at the mount of God. And he said unto Moses, I, thy father-in-law, Jethro, am come unto thee, and thy wife, and her two sons with her. And Moses went out to meet his father-in-law, and did obeisance, and kissed him. And they asked each other of their welfare, and they came into the tent. And Moses told his father-in-law all that the Lord had done unto Pharaoh and to the Egyptians for Israel's sake, and all the travail that had come unto them by the way, and how the Lord delivered them. And Jethro rejoiced for all the goodness which the Lord had done to Israel, and whom he had delivered out of the hand of the Egyptians. And Jethro said, Blessed be the Lord, who hath delivered you out of the hand of the Egyptians, and out of the hand of Pharaoh, who hath delivered the people from under the hand of the Egyptians. Now I know that the Lord is greater than all gods, for in the things wherein they dealt proudly, he was above them. And Jethro, Moses' father-in-law, took a burnt offering and sacrifices for God. And Aaron came, and all the elders of Israel, to eat bread with Moses' father-in-law before God. Here endeth the reading.
Oh,
brethren, I write no new commandment unto you, but an old commandment which ye had from the beginning. The old commandment is the word which ye have heard from the beginning. Again, a new commandment I write unto you, which thing is true in him and in you. Because the darkness is past, and the true light now shineth. He that saith he is in the light, and hateth his brother, is in darkness, even until now. He that loveth his brother abideth in the light, and there is none occasion of stumbling in him. But he that hateth his brother is in darkness, and walketh in darkness, and knoweth not whither he goeth, because that darkness has blinded him, his eyes. I write unto you, little children, because your sins are forgiven you for his name's sake. I write unto you, fathers, because you have known him that is from the beginning. I write unto you, fathers, because you have known him that is from the beginning. I write unto you, young men, because you have overcome the wicked one. I write unto you, little children, because you have known the Father. I have written unto you, fathers, because you have known him that is from the beginning. I have written unto you, young men, because you are strong, and the word of God abideth in you, and you have overcome the wicked one. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, and the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof. But he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. Here endeth the reading.
Amen.
Set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from all fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior.
Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all.
And with
Please be seated. Good evening and welcome to St. Michael's Church. Those of you who are new or visiting, it is a joy that you are here. If you would like to fill out a card so that we can put you on our email list and only bother you once or twice a week, that would be wonderful. And we can keep you apprised of what's happening here. If you'd like to get in touch and make an appointment to see me, I'm Ian Montgomery, the priest in charge here. I'd be happy to get to know you. Just briefly, I'd like to draw your attention to page 3 of the leaflet. A member of our choir wonderfully asked me, and by the way, it's not from an introit to Laetare Sunday, that was a month ago. This is Piero della Francesca's resurrection, and I think it's really rather wonderful. It isn't trying to be biblically correct. It is obviously a Renaissance tomb with Renaissance soldiers, not Roman soldiers. And Jesus is stepping out of the tomb. And he's holding the banner which is the Lamb of God. And I think this stepping out of the tomb is what a wonderful emblem that is of the resurrection. And how wonderful it would be if we, in fact, could step out of the tomb. Whatever our tomb is, wherever we find ourselves stuck, wherever we find ourselves in neutral, if we could step out of the tomb, what a joyful Eastertide that would be. And I invite you to take this home with you and reflect on it. Happy Easter to all of you. We hope that you will join us for some refreshments in the community house immediately following the service, just out the back door and across the driveway. Happy Easter.
Accept, O Lord, our intercessions for all mankind. Let the light of thy gospel shine upon all nations, and may as many as have received it live as becomes it. Be gracious unto thy church, and grant that every member of the same in his vocation and ministry may serve thee faithfully. Bless all in authority over us, and so rule their hearts and strengthen their hands, that they may punish wickedness and vice, and maintain thy true religion and virtue. Send down thy blessings, temporal and spiritual, upon all our relations, friends, and neighbors. Reward all who have done us good, and pardon all those who have done or wish us evil, and give them repentance and better minds. Be merciful to all who are in any trouble, and do thou, the God of pity, administer to them according to their several necessities. For his sake, who went about doing good, thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
May we say together, Almighty God,
Father of all mercies,
we, thine unworthy servants, do give thee most humble and tardy thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all men. We bless thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for thine inestimable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we show forth thy praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be amongst you and remain with you always.